Hey guys, so I'm continuing to talk about Metal Gear. So apparently just today, IGN released Why Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker is My Favorite Game of All Time. And that's speaking from the perspective of Greg Miller. For a long time, Metal Gear Solid 1 was his favorite game of all time. Now he explains why Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker is his favorite game of all time. Me, I don't know if I can... If that's true for me, but I'm amazed that Peace Walker is his favorite of all time. That makes me excited because Peace Walker to me is also such an amazing experience. It totally changed my view of the series as a whole. And that's something Metal Gear Solid 4 did for me, but Peace Walker like enhanced that so in a more subtle manner. You know, Metal Gear Solid 4 was like just really overt in this message, like, I'm gonna explain everything, you know, except for how Raiden came to be the way that he is, but everything, you know, boom, cutscenes. That's how Metal Gear Solid 4 did it, and it was, like, really over the top, just kind of throwing that message to you, and that's probably why, like, a lot of people kind of got turned off by Metal Gear Solid 4 after it came out, and, you know, there's Yachi's, like, Kojima needs an editor, and blah, blah, blah. Well, Peace Walker, it feels like Kojima got an editor or something like that. It's the most straight, as they say, storytelling is very lucid and very simple in Peace Walker. Like, people who've never played any other Metal Gear games before can come pick up Peace Walker and just understand the story, at least. There are many kind of subtle allusions to the other Metal Gear games. That's what gets me super excited about Peace Walker. But yeah, the storytelling is extremely straight. It's very directed at just a few concepts, like, it delves into, but it doesn't really go into, like, all these other things, like Metal Gear Solid 2, Metal Gear Solid 4, for example. These just go in all kinds of directions. War economy, child soldiers, genetic modification, it goes everywhere, right? Cyber terrorism, biological weapons. Peace Walker focuses very much on the Cold War, detente, nuclear deterrence. It's kind of the focus there, you know? And that's it, you know? And I think that makes it a very focused experience. Peace Walker also does, like Greg Miller mentions, so many things that Metal Gear as a series has never done before. But that's true for every iteration of Metal Gear Solid franchise. Going from Metal Gear Solid 2 to 3, Metal Gear Solid 3, the things that the franchise has never done before. 4, the same thing. Peace Walker definitely... so many things, but I think Peace Walker, just, there's so many things that are just like, whoa, like, amazing about it. Building your own freaking Metal Gear, but you never get to pilot it, but you do fight against it and make it stronger. You fight against different types of Metal Gears, different vehicles, there's co-op, there's online, there's all these other things, building your army of troops. And it's no longer as annoying as it is in Portable Ops because of the Fullerton thing. You know, you could use that parachute and just recruit people by tranking them. So, it's an amazing game, and I'm so glad there is such an appreciation for this game from someone as influential like Greg Miller. Because it's one of those games that somehow, because it's on a PlayStation Portable platform, or originally, it got ignored, you know? Like, I very much think that Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker could actually be considered to be Metal Gear Solid 5. It's that good. You know, we have Metal Gear Solid 5 now, but, like, it's that game is a continuation of Peace Walker. I feel like Peace Walker should very well be considered Metal Gear Solid 5. In fact, I think it would be amazing. This will not happen. But Kojima could have done, like, Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker with Fox Engine. Holy crap. And start that with 5. You know, and that's where 5 begins. Just a recreation of Peace Walker in Fox Engine. And then take us to Phantom Pain through that. I would have been mind-blowing. Now, he mentions Chrysalis as his favorite kind of boss fight. It's one of my least favorite boss fight in the series. It's Chrysalis. Seriously. Like, I hate that boss. So annoying. Especially the more difficult versions of it. I hate Chrysalis. But I actually made another video talking about my least favorite bosses in the series. And I'll upload that you know, probably sometime next week. But today, just know, I do not like Chrysalis. But, you know, Peace Walker does have, like, one of my favorite bosses ever. Which I also made another video for that where you guys get to find out. The really defining moment for me in Peace Walker is, the audio tapes that you get to listen to are amazing. And also the final dialogue between, not the final, but like the second to the last final dialogue between Kazuhira Miller and Big Boss, where Big Boss finally realizes, he finally comes to accept his code name. That moment was, it just brought me chills. Just that moment itself. But there's so many moments in that game, you know, like sending my tanks and my own Metal Gear against other troops and extra ops. You know, man, it's an amazing game. I definitely grant that it's definitely one of my favorite, I mean, I don't know. I can't really say if it's like my favorite Metal Gear game. Does it trump my favoriteness of Metal Gear Solid 1 or Metal Gear Solid 4? I don't know. Like, it's so hard to decide, but like there's a kind of a three-way tie for me. You know, I love Metal Gear Solid 1, I love Metal Gear Solid 4, I love Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker too. I think just in terms of content, Peace Walker definitely takes the cake. You know, you can even just one single playthrough of Peace Walker, you can play for 30 hours, and there's still enough content to keep you going. And that's not even including like some of the more bizarre content, like Monster Hunter boss battles. Like, seriously, that stuff is in there in this game. Some of the things are off-putting to me about Peace Walker, like the whole love cardboard box thingy that you could do. I know it's kind of comical, but I felt it was really out of place, especially the fact that, you know, you could kind of see through Podge's clothing was very distasteful, in my opinion. But yeah, fantastic game. I feel like if you're a Metal Gear fan and you haven't played Peace Walker, like seriously, at least just you gotta play Peace Walker, because Phantom Pain is years down the road, but Ground Zero is out. Like Peace Walker is an extremely, extremely important game to the franchise. I feel like Peace Walker, in a sense, I don't know, like, is it more important than 3? It's kind of, it's there, though. It, like, this importance, like, I don't think can be stressed enough. It really, yeah, just like how Metal Gear Solid 4 connects all the dots of the series, Peace Walker does that even further in a more subtle way, as I've mentioned before. And so, yeah, I think it's a fantastic game. I'm really glad it gets the mention that it does from Greg Miller. This is me signing off. I hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.